Pete brought him out some chicken. We went to eat at Ponderosa here in Mount Pleasant. And Pete brought Chewy out some chicken. He got to come with us rather than sit home alone all day or have Pam have to clean up after him.
Okay, Chew, that's it.
That's it.
Want some water? Want some water, Chew? Got water in there, see? Chewy. Hey, look it.
Sit on water, Dad. Don't want it. We'll save it for later. Guys, I'm in the car. It is, almost 5 o'clock. I don't have the key on. It was like 37, I think, outside. Made it up to 39 today. Not quite to 40. Here comes Petey. Anyway. I didn't talk in here, Sue. I didn't vlog at all, but I came up and saw my mom. She ate lunch, and then she wanted a nap after lunch, so we left, and we went and did her Christmas shopping for, you know, her presents. Oh, we went and got lunch, Ponderosa. What else? Oh, we stopped at Aldi for half and half, and I got some sour cream. And, oh yeah, we stopped at Meijer so I could get her pop, and she told me when I left today she wanted a cake. It's about the only thing she said that was not legible, the other word that you would use with verbal. I could understand, so, because she wasn't talking well today. But, so I found this really cute little layer cake. It's about 6 inches around, and it's all decorated with confetti, sugary things on it, and so I took her that and her 12-pack of Diet Coke, and she enjoyed some cake and some Diet Coke. And then we visited for like an hour. Wasn't it probably close to an hour?
Probably.
Pete and Chewy stayed in the car and walked around and stuff, but I went in and we had a great time. She was laughing and everything by the end. We were talking about old memories. Because this morning she was not really with it, didn't quite know who I was and everything, but by this afternoon when I went back, we started talking more. I was talking about Graham, her mom, and about playing the piano and all kinds of stuff. So, and then she started getting more with it and started getting more, you know. And the staff and the other residents that were in there, we stayed back in the dementia ward, and they were all talking and laughing and stuff, so it was kind of like a happy atmosphere today. So that was good. And I'll see her again Sunday after we go to Casey's. We'll come back here and see her and give her Christmas presents. So now it's time for me to drive back up north. So I will see you guys later. Bye. You're so patient, Maxwell. You're so patient with that almond. Is that good? You're just digging it right out of there, huh? Oh, what a smart bird. Oh, my Max. Look at you going to town. Chloe, you can tell me all you want, but if I give you an almond in the shell, you throw it on the floor. Right? So you just have to watch him eat his. You get yours out of the shell. Yeah, good bird, Max. He's a good bird. What's Elliot eating there? Oh, your hand is empty. You must have just ate it, whatever it was. What was you eating, Elliot? What was you eating? I didn't give you pasta tonight. What about you, Klinger? He says, I'm going to eat right now. She acts like she's mad at her food. She throws her head in there and bangs it around. Right, Phoebe? Bang it around. That's right. There's always food outside of her cage. She throws it around. What do you think, Klinger? Good stuff? Did you finish it? Good boy. Was it yummy out, Maxwell? Was it yummy? Huh? I love the way their black cages look against that gray and white curtain behind them, which is actually a king-size flannel sheet. Also has purple in it, but it looks from a distance gray and white. Yes, Chloe? You don't get yours in the shell, Chloe. Thank you.